Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's talk about backing up the files on your Mac using iCloud and why it really isn't a substitute for using a real backup like Time Machine. MacMost is supported by viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So often I hear from Mac users that they use iCloud to back up the files on their Mac. But iCloud really isn't a backup solution. If you want to back up the files on your Mac, you need to use Time Machine to do that. So iCloud, and specifically iCloud Drive and also iCloud Photos, is a way for you to sync your files and photos between your Macs and other Apple devices. So you could save a file on one Mac, say your desktop iMac, and then see that same file on your MacBook. You could also see those files on your iPhone and iPad. In addition to syncing your files across all your devices, it's also storing them on Apple's iCloud servers. So in a way, it does work a little bit like a backup, as it does provide you with some protection. But it's not a true backup. So there are two ways that iCloud Drive and iCloud Photos work as a backup. One is to protect you in case you lose your files. So you could lose your files if, say, your Mac or just your Mac's hard drive breaks. You could lose them if there's disaster, like say fire, flood, or maybe a toddler with a glass of milk. And of course, one of the most common things that could happen to your Mac is that it could get stolen, especially if you've got a MacBook that you carry around with you. In those cases, if you have all your files in iCloud Drive and all your photos in iCloud Photos, then you could get a new Mac and simply log onto iCloud and you'd have your files back. A second way that iCloud Drive and iCloud Photos act as a backup is that if you delete a file or photo, it's actually moved to a recently deleted folder. And it'll be there for 30 days. So if you accidentally delete a file, you can actually go to iCloud.com and view the recently deleted files in the iCloud Drive section or the recently deleted photos in the Photos section and recover an item that you accidentally deleted. You can also see recently deleted photos in the Photos app. Now the same is true if you're using another cloud solution. If you're using Dropbox or Microsoft or Google, you also have this second location where your files are stored. And if disaster strikes, you can log back onto your cloud account and find those files there. Although different services may vary for how long they keep deleted items. Now Time Machine is a very different thing. It's a local backup. So you're backing up to a local hard drive, like maybe one of these that you've connected directly to your Mac or perhaps to your network at home. It's an incremental backup, which means if you have 1,000 files and you only change 3 of them, the next backup would only update those 3 files. It doesn't need to do anything with the other 997. So incremental backups could be very quick. Now it also saves deleted files. So if you delete a file from a folder, Time Machine will still have that in an older version of that folder. That's why it's called Time Machine. You can go back in time to find an old file. And there isn't a 30-day limit either. As a matter of fact, the limit really depends on how much space is on the drive. So you get a nice big drive, you could have deleted files going back years. And Time Machine also saves changes to files. So if you change a file today, after a backup, you'll have a backup of today's file, but you'll also have a backup of how the file was yesterday. And depending how much space you've got, you could have many versions of this file going all the way back to the original version you created. Now a lot of Apple apps like Pages, Numbers, and Keynote already save old versions of the file inside the file itself. So if you're working on a Pages document, you can revert to earlier versions. But most third-party apps don't do this. So if you change a file today, that file is just the current version of the file. If you want to go back to how the file was yesterday, last month, or 6 months ago, having Time Machine is invaluable because you can go back in time and grab that old version of the file. Another thing about Time Machine is it backs up everything on the drive. It's backing up your preferences files. It's backing up local files like things in your movies folder, maybe your iMovie projects, anything you've saved to other local folders. It's saving even your applications and the system files. Time Machine will even save things that are on other external drives connected to your Mac. iCloud, of course, is only going to save the files that are in iCloud Drive. That may be just your iCloud Drive folder or it could be your documents folder and your desktop folder as well depending on your settings. Time Machine can also be used to do a complete restore from this local drive. So whether you get a new Mac or you're simply installing a new hard drive in a Mac where the drive has failed, you can take your Time Machine back up and you can restore everything from this backup to get to the state you were before. With iCloud Drive and iCloud Photos, you can just pull those old files in. But you're still going to have to manually restore your apps, your settings, and you may lose any files that were saved locally. So there are three ways that iCloud Drive falls short as a backup solution. The first is that saving deleted files for 30 days simply isn't enough. Sometimes you delete a file and you right away know you made a mistake. But other times you may not notice for months that you accidentally deleted a file. And if it was just saved in iCloud Drive, then that deleted copy is now gone. But with Time Machine, you can go back and find it. iCloud Drive only keeps the most recent version of files. So if you have a Photoshop file or a movie script that you're working on and you make some changes and then the next day you realize you want to go back to your previous version, you're not going to be able to do that with iCloud Drive. But you can do that with Time Machine. And iCloud Drive is only going to save what you put in your iCloud Drive folder and documents and desktop if you have that option turned on. It's not going to save things in other local folders or external drives. Even Apple here has a page here on backing up your Mac. And notice that it says that Time Machine is for backups, whereas using iCloud is for storing things. Now certainly using iCloud Drive and iCloud Photos is better than nothing, and it saved a lot of people who haven't otherwise set up any kind of backup. But you shouldn't look at it as your backup solution. You should get a Time Machine drive and start using Time Machine. I would never use a Mac or any computer without having an actual backup. So my recommendation is firmly to use both. Use iCloud Drive and iCloud Photos because it's great to have access to all of your files across all of your devices. But also have a real backup like Time Machine. In fact, you may want to consider having a second backup, either using Time Machine or some other backup software, or maybe even doing a real online backup, sending them to an online service rather than a local hard drive. In fact, that's what I do. I use iCloud Drive, I use Time Machine for a local backup, and I use Backblaze for an online backup. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.